Hi there, another battery for video. It's a bit this time about the extensions you can use in battery 4 and which one you can import. You can't all import them, but a lot of them you can play, like the asset files, NPC extensions, I mean the NPC ones, the reactor ones, the .map extensions. You can all play them in battery. You know, you just go to the files and locate them on your hard disk. And let's take battery 3 for example. You know, battery 3, battery 2, battery 1. You can all play them and import them into battery 4. So let's say a kit. It's taking a bit long now because I got some other programs working at the site. So anyway, you see, you can all play them, load them into your battery 4 thing. But you can also import them. This is just opening and play them, and then save them, for example, or create your own kit. But you can also import them. Let's go back. You see, now you got the import function available. It's not for the kits itself. That's a bit too bad, but doesn't matter that much. You see, now the import function doesn't work. But anyway, it doesn't matter that much. You can just import the whole acoustic kits section, for example. So you want to go to import. You give it a name, like a battery 3 in this case. That would be, you know, add new battery 3. And then you would give the subtitle for the subbank. And you would say acoustic kits. So that's how you would do that. Another way, that's what I did, is to just import the whole battery library at once, and there are more than 20,000 samples, so it's quite a lot. But yeah, you could do that, and the way it looks will be like this. Sample battery 3, here I did all, so it looks a bit chaotic, but these are all the sounds or samples, whatever you want to name them, that are from battery 3. And you know, I don't mind doing it like this, because you can all pre-listen them, pre-hear them, and create your own kit, and you know, make your custom kit and save that custom kit, so you have your favorite kits. And a nice thing about this is, if you do this, right click your mouse on it, find in Explorer, or it's on my other screen, you get to see where it's from. So this one is from battery 3 acoustic kits, heavy rockets, and so you know, that's with all like this one is from what would that be? You see, beatbox Elliot samples. So you still have a bit of reference where it was from. So anyway, that's it with the import. I did it like this because it's fast. Yeah, it's a pretty fast way. I don't know what's the smartest way, because you get this huge list with samples. So it's not that neat. It would be easier if you just do, like I said before, no, just import acoustic kit, tag it, you know, name it, give it the sub, you know, something here, acoustic kit, and then the second one, it would be production kits. So then you have a little bit more inside. So I think I'm gonna change it to that, because yeah, I'm not that satisfied with having that huge list. I don't mind that much, but I don't know, I think I'm gonna change it. But for me, I like to use sounds from different, you know, not label them too much, because you can change, manipulate the sound so much. It doesn't have to be, you know, it's got nothing to do with percussion or whatever, or acoustic. Yeah, acoustic perhaps it does, but if you manipulate it enough, it won't be so. Anyway, that was what I wanted to show you. I hope it's clear to you. If it's not, just leave a comment and I will answer it. And I got some other videos. So if you don't, if you want to keep updated, please subscribe. If you liked it, you can hit the like button. Would appreciate that. So yeah, that was it for now. I hope to see you again. Thanks for watching. Have a nice evening, y'all. Peace.